Today in our 2013 Dodge Charger, we're going to be installing CURT's Class 2 1¼-inch trailer hitch receiver, part number C12064. And this is what our hitch is going to look like when it's installed. As you can see, it's mostly hidden completely behind the bumper, and you're just going to be able to see the small receiver tube up the bottom. This is a Class 2 1¼-inch by 1¼-inch receiver, so it's going to be great for bike racks, cargo carriers, and very light towing. It features hoop-style safety chain loops, so it has a nice large opening that'll accommodate just about any size safety chain. It uses a 1/2-inch hitch pin and clip.
CURT does recommend that you use a stabilization strap when hauling any non-trailer loads.
It features a 350-pound tongue weight, that's the force going down on top of the receiver, and a 3,500-pound gross towing capacity, that's how much it can pull behind it. You do want to make sure to check your vehicle's owner's manual to ensure you're not exceeding its capacities. And now to help you with deciding on accessories, I've got some measurements for you. From the ground to the top inside edge of the receiving tube, measures about 8¾ inches. And from the center of the hitch pin hole to the edge of the rear bumper, it measures about 8 inches. We'll begin our installation under the vehicle by lowering down our exhaust. Depending if you have a V6 or a V8, your exhaust may look a little bit different. We have the V8 model, so we're gonna be lowering it. The V8 has two mufflers, so it's gonna be a bit larger, and there's gonna be a bit more hangers to remove. Spray some silicone lubricant on your hanger, and then you can just pry that off. We'll then remove the rearmost hanger. You'll now repeat this same process on the other side if you have the V8 exhaust system. On the V8 model, you'll also need to remove one more exhaust hanger closer to the front of the vehicle, just in front of the two studs with the springs. Now that we've got all our exhaust hangers removed, we'll remove the two nuts located here on our driver's side exhaust. You'll use a 13-millimeter socket to remove those nuts. Now we can remove the muffler on our driver's side. So this entire portion from here to there is going to be removed. Support it, move it towards the rear to get it off the studs, and then we'll drop it down. We can now set this aside. Now we'll clean out the weld nuts on each side, spray some spray lubricant up inside there, and use a small bristled brush to clean out the holes. We'll start on our driver's side. Take the coiled end of your fish wire, we're gonna put it through the frontmost hole, and we're just gonna feed it back to the large opening there and pull it through. We'll now slide our spacer over the coiled end and thread on one of our carriage bolts. Push the spacer up into the frame. Followed by your carriage bolt and pull it back down. We'll repeat this same procedure on our passenger side in the two open holes. Now with the next set of hands, we'll lift our hitch into position. You need to feed your fish wires down through the holes. And you'll also need to put the passenger side up over the exhaust first before we can get it into position. Once you get one bolt started on each side, the hitch will hold itself into position. When you install your bolts, you want to make sure that you put a conical tooth washer on it with the teeth facing up towards the hitch. You'll install bolts with conical tooth washers in any location where there's a weld nut in your frame. And you'll use the flange nuts provided in the kit wherever you fed down a carriage bolt. Now tighten down all of your hardware using a 19-millimeter socket. Now torque all of your hardware to the specifications in your instructions. Now reinstall our muffler. And now we can reinstall our exhaust hangers. And that completes our installation of CURT's Class 2 1¼-inch trailer hitch receiver on our 2013 Dodge Charger.